Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can use fwrite function to write structure into a file and how you can use fread function to read structure from file with the help of C programming. Before starting, you can note how you can search my YouTube channel. You can type my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos here. Now I am going to demonstrate you the use of fwrite and fread function. So I will be implementing two separate codes. First will be demonstrating the use of fwrite and another will be demonstrating the use of fread. So first I am including two header files, stdio.h and stdlib.h. Now I am going to define main function. Inside main function, I am declaring a file pointer and then I have to declare a structure variable. So here I am declaring a structure variable which belongs to student. So first I have to declare the structure. So before main, I am going to declare a structure whose name is student and it will be containing two members. Roll number and name. Roll number is of type int and name is of type character array. Now I can declare a structure variable. So struct student s. This s is a variable of struct student. Now I have to open the file. So name of file is student.txt and I am going to open it in WB mode. So W is for write and B is for binary. So whenever you use fwrite and fread functions for reading and writing structure into file, you have to use binary mode because fread and fwrite works for binary data only. So here, after opening the file, I have to check whether the file is opened successfully or not. So for that purpose, I have implemented this if condition, which is checking whether the file pointer is containing null or not. So if it is containing null, then I can print this error message, that is cannot open file, and then I can call exit function. Otherwise this if condition will be false and the statements which are available after if will be executed. So now I have to read roll number and name from user. So for that purpose, I am writing this printf and then through scanf I am going to read roll number from user in s.rollNumber variable. Now I have to read name of student. So the message enter name will be displayed. Before reading name, I have to call this function fflush which will clear the buffer memory. And then through getS, I am going to read name of student. So this way I have received roll number and name from user with the help of scanf and getS function. Now I can write this structure variable in a single statement into a file. So with the help of fwrite function, I am going to write this structure variable into file. So for that purpose, I am going to pass 4 arguments in fwrite. So fwrite is writing structure into file. So now you have to understand these 4 arguments which I have passed in fwrite. So first argument is address of structure variable, that is s. Second is denoting size of struct student and third is denoting quantity. So s is a single variable, that's why I am writing 1, and fourth is destination, that is fp, which is pointing to student.txt. So this data will be stored in student.txt file with the help of file pointer. Now I can print a message for user. Data is stored successfully. So this message will be displayed on output screen. And then fclose fp. So this way I have implemented first part of this video, which is demonstrating the use of fwrite. So the data will be stored in file, that is student.txt, and data will be stored in binary format. And this program is saved in test.c. The path of this file is ctcnbin, that you can see on title bar of the program, ctcnbin. So this student.txt will be available on that path, that is ctcbin folder. Now I am going to execute this program. So you can see it is asking for roll number and name. So I have entered roll number as 11 and name as Sanjay. And you can see it is showing the message data is stored successfully in the file. So now I have to check whether the data is stored successfully or not. So for that purpose, I have to open bin folder that is available in CTC. So I have opened bin folder. Now here I have to search student.txt. So I have pressed S. So the files which starts from name S are available here. And you can see student.txt is available here. And here you can see the data is available, but it is in binary format. So you can't see roll number, but you are able to see a name. So whenever you use fwrite function, data is stored in binary formats. So you can't read all the data clearly. To read that data clearly, you have to use fwrite function. So this is the first part of this video where I have demonstrated you the use of fwrite. Now I am going to change this code. In place of write mode, I am going to use read mode. And I am going to change these instructions. So you can see the code. First I have included two header file, then student structure, then file pointer, then structure variable. Then this time file is opened in read mode. And then if condition is checking whether the file is opened successfully or not. So now I have to read data from file. So for that purpose, I am using fread ampersand s size of struct student then 1, fp. So this fread statement will read data from file. So it reads struct from file. So file is denoted with the help of file pointer. It will read one record from file and that will be stored inside s variable. So file might be containing more than one student records. So it will be reading first record that is available in the file. Now I have to show the received values to the user. So for that purpose, I am going to write these printf statements. And then fclose. So you can read these statements. First I have used fread, then I have called printf statement twice. So first is printing roll number and second is printing name with the help of s variable. And s is receiving data from file, that is fp file pointer. And name of file is student.txt. So now while executing this code, I don't have to enter anything. The data will be received from file and it will be displayed on output screen automatically. So now I am going to execute the code. You can see on output screen, the data which I have stored in the file is displayed on output screen, that is roll number 11 and name equals to Sanjay. So this way, with the help of fwrite, I am able to write structure into file, and with the help of fread function, I am able to read the data which is stored in file in form of structure variable, and I have displayed that data on output screen. So this is all about fread and fwrite function, which are writing and reading structure in file with the help of file handling in C programming. I hope you have understood whatever I have demonstrated you in this video. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos there.